seen this week after a helicopter crashed on the roof of UNM Hospital. And today, crews finally got that aircraft down. KOAT Action 7 News reporter Regina Reese has the story.
Well, this was a major operation. Now, take a look at this video of that crane lifting the helicopter off of the roof. Now, the big challenge here, you can see all of those power lines in the shot. Power had to be turned off. Now, this all started when something went wrong with that helicopter on Wednesday.
It hit the side of the building so hard that pieces went everywhere and it started smoking.
The terrifying scene as a medical transport helicopter takes off. Then seconds later encounters dangerous problems.
It started spinning around in circles, and then it started to teeter a little bit, and I guess the wind caught it or something because it went straight down and hit the building.
The helicopter stayed on UNMH's roof for 3 days as crews investigated and prepared to take it down. Heavy equipment was brought in to take down the crashed helicopter early Saturday morning. It was quite the process. From Sky 7, you can see crews loading up a large box with the rotors. Another load with jet fuel is carefully taken down. Finally, the crane lowers a large hook. Then crews attach that hook to the top of the helicopter, and it's slowly lifted from the rooftop and lowered to the ground. Once there, it's gently placed on a flatbed truck.
I think it's been amazing. You know, all the bits and pieces have come together.
With the helicopter gone, there's a lingering issue. There's damage to the roof that will affect when medical flights can land at UNMH once again.
We couldn't do a total assessment until the helicopter was removed. What really had happened was when it went on its side, the rotors were still turning, and that breached the ceiling.
They don't know the exact extent of those breaches, but that will be evaluated. FEMA has been on scene doing stress analysis on the roof. UNMH is the only level 1 trauma center in the state and the only pediatric emergency room, so it's crucial for helicopters to be able to land at the hospital.
It's critical that we get back up as soon as we can, and we're trying to do everything we can to accomplish that.
For right now, UNMH will use Presbyterian's helipad for patients. They aren't going to land at Johnson Field anymore and hope their helipad will be cleared for landings very soon.
UNMH evacuated about 18 patients to other areas of the hospital right after the crash, and we're told those patients will stay in those areas for now.